one of the things I suppose that I like about my job, if you like to call it a job, is that I can sort of choose if there's something that I like. Maybe it's a landscape, flowers, musical instruments, animals. Gives me an excuse to kind of play around with some of those ideas, you know, and spend time observing wildlife or just drawing and getting ideas. The whole natural world is just an incredible resource, isn't it, for an artist? I've always loved, well, everything in nature, you know, animals, flowers, everything that moves, basically. From the earliest days, when I was at school, I mean, I was selling my work. I had my first one-man show in Hong Kong when I was 18 years of age. I think at that time I was the youngest European artist ever to have a one-man show in Hong Kong. To me, art has always been about reaching people. There was never a picture that I painted that I painted for the purpose of stashing in some cupboard or putting under the bed. I'm a communicator and I paint for people. I paint so that people can enjoy my work, and obviously, I mean, I sell it. I use that, obviously, as a means of making a living, but you know what? To me, obviously, it's so much more than just making a living, because it's a passion that, you know, you have within you to reach out. I talk often about, well, I'd say the feel-good factor that comes from my work. I believe that through the use of the colours and the imagery, and people have said to me, you know, many times in the past that they get a lot of energy. There was one lady in particular that has a piece of mind. She says that every morning she sits in front of my picture and just kind of like, it just helps her kind of calm down and face the day. But to me, the challenge is to convey something powerful, you know, to step beyond the mere representation of a subject or a theme. A lot of my studio works will start with drawings. I mean, for example, I'll walk through the garden and just look very closely at everything and take my sketch pad and draw stuff. Or if I'm out on a travel somewhere, I'll just take my sketchbook with me. And basically, I just think through ideas, and then I come back into the studio. And I may start with, usually it starts with a drawing. I used to paint very much directly from life, but now I prefer to work from a drawing. I believe the way I paint, the way people respond, and certainly the way that I've seen people respond to my work, is very similar in the way that they would respond to music. So, for example, if you're listening to a piece of music that you love, you don't necessarily know why you love it, but there's something about that piece that makes you feel a certain way, helps you reflect on something, speaks to you, enriches you in some way. Yeah, I just love the idea of creating a kind of an atmosphere, like maybe in a club late at night where it's all kind of hazy with the lights and it's just the sound of everything going, to just you just hear the sound, and it creates an atmosphere for you personally to kind of travel somewhere in your imagination. I don't tend to like write specific commentaries about my paintings saying this is what this flower means, this is what this means, this is what this means. I tend to paint them and just offer them to people, and then they can bring their own history, their own ideas, their own experience to it, and you have a kind of interface, like a kind of exchange between the person and the painting.